Students, today we are going to start a new chapter, Strategies for Enhancement in Food Production. In this chapter, we are going to see how we'll get the improvement in food production by plant breeding, tissue culture, single cell protein, biofortification. Next, we are going to study about the maintenance of dairy farms, poultry farms, what is apiculture, what is pisciculture. Then we are going to see what is animal breeding, plant breeding, about mutation breeding, and what is heterosis. Then we'll see how plant breeding is applied for disease resistant crops. We'll be seeing what is biofortification and what is tissue culture, its techniques and its application. So let us start with the proper maintenance of dairy farms and poultry farms. Okay, first let us see what is animal husbandry. It is the scientific management of farm animals or domestic animals, including their feeding. So we are going to see the proper maintenance of dairy farms and poultry farms. Before going to that, let us see first what is animal husbandry. It is the scientific management of farm animals or domestic animals, which includes their feeding, breeding and disease control. Okay, so how to breed and raise the domestic animals, the entire is known as animal husbandry. Now let us see what is dairy farm management. Okay, it is defined as the management of cattle for milk and its products for human consumption. This is the proper definition of it, dairy farm management. So dairy farm in management involves the various steps taken to improve the yield and also the quality of milk. Okay. So what is white revolution here? It refers to increased production of milk by the use of improved varieties of cows and buffaloes. Now we'll see the various steps to improve the quality of breeds. Okay, so how we can get good quality breeds? So selection of good and high yielding breeds is very important step. Then the breed should be familiar with the local climate. Now the breed should be disease resistant and also it should be controlled, the breeding, controlled breeding. These are the various steps to improve the quality of breeds. The next we'll see what is dairy farm or cattle farm management. It means the management of cattle. As you know, cattle means cows, buffaloes, etc. And management of cattle is how the cows and buffaloes are properly managed for milk production. So dairy farm management involves a balanced diet, cleanliness. So cleanliness should be maintained in both the cattle and also the handler. Proper shelter should be taken under roof sheds and proper hygiene. Okay, and it includes vaccination, medication, isolation. And the diseased animal should be isolated to avoid or prevent infection. The next we are going to see about the poultry farm management. So let us discuss now here what is poultry farming. What is poultry farming? So poultry farming is the domestication and rearing of birds for eggs and meat and also for feathers. So domestication and rearing. Rearing means taking care of. So all these are the the next is poultry management. It includes the scientific techniques which helps to maximize the efficiency of production of birds with minimum investment. So here how we'll get the maximum production of birds with minimum investment. This is called as poultry management. Now we'll see the steps for poultry management. What are the steps to be taken care? Excuse me. The birds should be kept in rainproof place or in proper sheds. They should be provided nutritious food. They should be protected against predators. Now there is fresh supply of clean and fresh water continuously, adequate lighting and ventilation, proper sanitation and hygiene, proper temperature should also be maintained. In this slide, we are going to discuss about animal breeding. So, what is animal breeding? Selective cross-fertilization of animals of desired breeds. So, breeding is cross-fertilization of animals of desired breeds. This is the proper definition. Now, animal breeding is of two types, inbreeding and outbreeding. So, first let us discuss about inbreeding. Inbreeding refers to the mating or breeding of closely related animals of the same breed for 4 to 6 generations. When breeding is done between closely related animals for 4 to 6 generations, is known as inbreeding. Okay? Now, the advantages of inbreeding is it increases homozygosity. What is homozygosity? It increases the chances of offspring. Now, inbreeding helps in the accumulation of superior genes in a breed and elimination of undesirable genes. It increases the productivity, but continuous inbreeding will reduce the fertility and also the productivity, leading to inbreeding depression. Okay? Inbreeding increases the productivity, but continued inbreeding will reduce the fertility, leading to inbreeding depression. So, to overcome this inbreeding depression, the animals are bred with unrelated animals. That is known as outbreeding. So, the next second breeding method is outbreeding. What is outbreeding? It is the breeding of unrelated animals. When breeding is done between unrelated animals, it is outbreeding. So you can define it as breeding of two animals. When breeding is done between two animals of different breeds, it is known as outbreeding. So outbreeding is of three types: outcrossing, crossbreeding, and interspecific hybridization. First, let us see what is outcrossing. It is mating of animals within the same breed, but they do not have a common ancestor. Again, I say, when breeding of two animals of the same breed, but without a common ancestor for 4 to 6 generations, is known as outcrossing. So, with this method, we can overcome inbreeding depression. The second type of outbreeding is crossbreeding. When breeding occurs between two animals of different breeds, they may belong to the same species, it is called crossbreeding. Okay, here different breeds. You see, in the first one, same breed, in the second one, different breeds. Then what is the third type? Interspecific hybridization. So, hybridization means a mating method. Here, mating of animals is done of two different species. Okay, so the male and female animals, they belong to two different species, hence the word interspecific. And as the process is hybridization, the product obtained is called a hybrid. These are the three definitions, very important for your board exam. And what is the advantage of this outbreeding? It results in a sterile hybrid. And the hybrid is sturdier and hardier than the parent species. Sturdier and hardier means they are quite suitable for hard work. Okay? Like bull. So, these are the two advantages of interspecific hybridization. Thank you. Hope you understood this. Stay home, stay safe. Goodbye.